Hey everybody, Vicki Fitch here, your direct sales expert and the host of Vicki Fitch Live, A Fresh Perspective. As you guys know, on the first Wednesday of every month, we do the Evict The Bully In Your Head series. I have a new book coming out called Evict The Bully In Your Head, where we're reminded that there's a bully in our head, right? And it didn't start as a big, bulky bully. It started as an itty-bitty baby, and we clothed it, and we fed it, and we nurtured it, and gave it a safe place to live. And now it's turned into this big, monstrous beast. And we're going to teach you how to evict the bully. So on the first Wednesday of every month, we have a guest that comes on that has successfully evicted that bully. It doesn't mean it doesn't return once in a while to visit, but tonight's guest is a superstar. Her name is Abigail. Abigail, we call her Abby K, right? Because she's promoting Abby K Life. She is an entrepreneur, a CEO. She's been a model. She's in the fitness industry. You know, her list of accolades is like longer than my leg. And if you guys know I'm 6 foot tall, that is a very long list. So I really want her to share her story with you and give you strength and hope to understand that she went through trial, she went through tragedy, and she turned them into triumph. Those of you that are watching or that are listening on iTunes and Stitcher, we thank you for being here. And I encourage you to go watch episode, and I forgot my episode number. Let's see, I'll have to look it up in a minute, but we're episode, was it 12? I think today is actually our 12th, our 1 year technical anniversary of the show of Evict the Bully in Your Head. So without further ado, let me introduce Miss Abby K. Abby, how are you, my friend?
I'm good, Vicki. How are you?
Oh, I am awesome, sweetie. And you know, I sit here and I look at you and I'm enamored by you. Not only are you kind and sweet and beautiful, grounded in your Christian faith, but you deliver to people each and every day. You deliver recipes, you deliver fitness, you deliver, you know, the understanding of ketones, you deliver, you know, you're a mom, you bring your daughter into your scopes and your broadcasts, your Facebook lives. You just wrap the package so well in a beautiful bow. And I'm just so impressed with you, Abby. So thank you for being here and sharing with the audience.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be on your show. And I adore you. We've worked together and you have been such an instrumental part of this year and just a lot of my journey in really developing a lot of inner strength when felt like my world was just kind of caving in. So, definitely not an expert in evicting the bully in my mind, but I sure have read a lot about it and I got a lot of gold nuggets. So I don't know where we want to begin.
Well, we'll start kind of with, I usually have a beginning piece where I ask you a couple of questions, kind of finding out, you know, why don't you just start out by telling us a little bit, like, who do you really admire? Who's somebody that's really inspired you in your life?
Man, I would definitely have to say my dad. I look up to my dad a lot. He was a hardcore athlete growing up and really instilled that discipline and that drive in me. A God-fearing man. He's a pastor. I'm a preacher's daughter, you know, but he's always shown me tough love, but good love when I needed it the most. When things seem to be, you know, falling apart, he's the one in the corner. He's the one just, you know, really speaking truth into my life. So I love the example that he set, and it's been really handy in my career and business life as well.
Well, you know, and that's the thing is that a lot of times, you know, parents aren't perfect, right? I mean, we know as parents, we're not perfect. We know that we try really hard with our kids. We're a product of our own environment. The things that our parents taught us, some good and some bad. Let's face it, sometimes we don't even recognize that what our parents are teaching us aren't, you know, are really something their parents taught them that we kind of want to erase, that they're not, it's not supportive. It's not kind and endearing. I know that my own father, you know, when I was a kid, I never felt like I was good enough. And that's one of the reasons I'm really familiar with the Evict the Bully in Your Head, because I didn't feel good enough or smart enough for him. A straight A student, but I got excessive talking, you know, da, da, da. It's like, there was always, no matter how good I thought I was, there was always some letdown. And so I recognized later as an adult that my father did the best he could, that he had a bully in his head that was that, you know, needed to be evicted as well. But I didn't have the verbiage to use that. So we know that your dad probably wasn't perfect, but the fact that it sounds like he was one of your heroes is like, you know, it's admirable, because we know that we can still admire people that aren't perfect, right?
Totally. And, you know, a lot of the things that I've had to assess in my later years, it's like your greatest strengths really are your greatest weaknesses. And, you know, my siblings could internalize different things that he said or did in a totally different way than I did, based on my needs and my love language. And, you know, I just remember, even growing up, our conversations at times were very rewards based. I grew up in Indianapolis. It's the Hoosier basketball state, and all parents and children, if you're in the sport, it's obsessive. And, you know, the conversations there are, how many points did you score? How many drives did you give up? How many, you could score 30 points, but we're going to talk about that missed free throw. What the coach say after the game? And a lot of my mindset was developed around performance-based activity. And, you know, growing up, you know, you're done being an athlete, or maybe it's taken away. For me, it was, with 3 torn ACLs. You know, maybe you didn't get the scholarship that you wanted, or you lost the position at work that you wanted. And all of a sudden, you know, for myself, this girl who was performance-based, and you don't get the recognition that you once graded yourself off of. When you're adult, you don't have people assessing your moves, your plays, telling you good job. And I think that is when you can really get that loud bully in your head, if you're not hearing those accolades. And for someone who grew up with them, that's where my bully can take over, is when I'm not hearing much. It's I'm critical of my game, and there's not a lot of people building you up. And as a Christian mom and woman, it's where I've had to find my truth and who I am, not based on what I do, but whose I am and what God says about me, regardless of what my career looks like, what my parenting looks like, you know, what my home looks like. It's, who am I? Whose am I? You know, that's who I am. So that's part of fighting the bully, I think.
Amen to that. And I think that you're absolutely right. There's so much to be said for identifying whose we are. You know, I always say I have an audience of one, and that's Jesus Christ. It's not my job to try and cater to you or him or her or them. My job is to cater to him. And as long as I'm serving him and I'm doing the right thing, then that's all I have to work with, right? And when I stumble, when I trip, then I get to get back up, brush myself off, and say, I'm sorry, daddy, you know, I'm going to do better. You know, I'm going to work better. But he's not going to be identifying every time, saying, well, you did really good, but you didn't see that stone there, or you didn't see that hole, or you didn't see that. And that's what I think, where our parents have those bullies in their head, or our friends or our neighbors. So really quick, I'm going to go ahead and pop in and say hello to some people. I see Jay Garrett in the house and says, this is a great topic. You guys, do me a favor. If you haven't already, share this broadcast out. I bet you guys know some people that have a bully in their head. I bet you have one in your head. And I hope that you guys are getting some value here out of, you know, what we're talking about today and what's going on. But I want you to share the broadcast out. Again, there's so many people that need hope and encouragement, and Abby's going to do a really, really great job of doing that. I see Stacey Lynn is here, Melanie Weiser, of course, Mr. Rob Hicks, our producer, is here. April, thank you for being here. And I hear somebody says that there's something coming through my headset. Hopefully not, because I actually turned it off when you guys posted that, and I turned it back on only right now. So hopefully it isn't for me. I don't hear it, so I don't know if anybody else does, but I'll keep turning it off while Abby's talking, just in case. And I want to tell you guys again that our here that have downloaded the broadcast, I hope you'll go see episode 12 either at VickiFitch.com. Go to the Vicki Fitch Live tab, go to YouTube, and again, watch episode 12 with Abigail Epps-Kluttz, aka Miss Abby K. And you guys will get to see again her beautiful smile, her beautiful countenance, and the opportunity to connect with her on a level. And we're going to give you an opportunity to also visit her website and stuff later on in the broadcast. Before we dive into some of these other pieces, we want to tell you, because community is really important. important. Abby just was talking about when people aren't giving you accolades, when they're not supporting you, when you're struggling, then things get even harder, right? And so we have a community. I have a community called the Entrepreneurial Rockstars, and I really encourage you guys to join it. We have a Rockstar of the Week program. So each week, except on the Evict the Bully in Your Head series, we bring in a cameo guest, somebody that's got a business that we can give you a chance to do a quick live stream to an audience of people that are safe, right? That want to help you. This group of people wants to give at least as much as they get. So if you go to VickiFitch.com and click the freebies tab, you can join the Entrepreneurial Rockstars, and we'd love to welcome you in, give you a support group of people that are going to encourage you and motivate you in your business and on your journey. So thanks guys for being here. I'm going to go ahead and, oh, I see Mr. Joe Girard is in the house. I have to tell you, you guys, Joe is going to be on my show, but he's going to be on He Said, Red Said as well. He is the male version of me. We will talk about that later, but Joe, welcome. Leroy Chapman in the house. Welcome to be here. I'm so glad that you're here, sweetheart. I see a bunch of other people have popped in again. And if you haven't hit that button, that share button, hit it now. Go get them. Come on, Tiger. Hit that button. Share it out, because again, Abby's got a great story to share. So Abby, let's talk about, you know, let's kind of go back a little bit, because you were talking about you're a preacher's daughter, right? You grew up in a Christian home, and a lot of people think that that's a perfect environment, you know, and again, I know your dad was your hero. I know he was great, but did you feel like you were, you know, besides the fact that you got identified what things you missed and what things you didn't, did you feel like there was some kind of stigma attached to the preacher's daughter? Did you feel like you had different expectations in the community, not just at home?
I think when I moved to Oklahoma, they identified the preacher's daughter as a little crazy, but they already knew. There's already country songs written about us, but you know, in Indianapolis, it was where we began when I was young. I think it was easy. I think it was easy to feel sheltered, and I think growing up under such a strong spiritual household, I don't know, at times hid under it and didn't sometimes develop my own spiritual relationship with God. It's easy when you grow up in a church to fall into the legalism, to show up to church every Sunday, to, you know, memorize the scriptures, to act the way you're supposed to act. And, you know, I think that really caught up with me later in my life. I had to learn what an authentic relationship with Christ looked like, especially, you know, moving away so young at the age of 20 outside of my parents' home. Like, who am I when I'm not the preacher's daughter? Who am I when I'm not surrounded by an entire community where if I held hands at a movie theater on Friday night, Dad was going to find out, like, you know, who am I? And I think even as a middle child preacher's daughter, it really has caused me to have a huge identity crisis in my life. And I feel like, you know, I'm coming in late to the game. I've got big stuff going on, and it's shaken me. And it's an ongoing process towards sanctification and learning who you are when nobody's watching, how you speak to people, how you treat people, the decisions that you make. And my unbelievably, you know, I am a fool sometimes, but I have learned some hard lessons, and I feel like my relationship with Christ just flourishes in pain and in my stupid decisions and trying to do it all on my own. So, these last couple of years have definitely, you know, I'm just hitting 30, and I feel like I am just discovering what it's like to have my own authentic relationship. You know, that I can't hide behind. I can't hide behind that preacher's daughter. I'm not 16 anymore. You know, not everybody's watching. So,
well, you know, and I think that there's two sides to that coin. And you guys, those of you that are here live, I'd love for you to again hit that share button if you haven't already, because I think she just hit on some things that are really critical. You know, she said she had an identity crisis, right? And I bet if you are here in this room right now, you've probably had one yourself. Whether you go preteens, I mean, let's face it, sometime between preteens and teens, we all have our own identity crisis. We all trying to figure out who we are, what we're about, you know, what we're going to stand for. Are we going to allow other bullies to bully other kids? Or are we going to hide in the shadows? Are we going to step up and stand out? Or are we going to, you know, try and blend in because we don't know what to do with ourselves? Neither one of those options is bad. It just is part of life. It's part of our journey, right? And Abby's talking about one of the things that she said, I'm going to have to disagree with, which you're late in the game. You know, it depends on what you mean by late in the game. But, you know, as there's so many people right now that are 40 and 50, Abby, that haven't figured it out yet, that are listening to you right now going, you know, I wish I would have found out when I was 30. So you, as a 30-year-old, share this with me, or as someone that's in that mid-range, share with me what it is that got you to that point. Is it, did you just have to, you know, we're going to talk about how you got dropped to your knees, but it was just that drop to your knees that did it? Or was there something else that said, it's time to change? You know, was there a person, was that, what was that trigger, Abby? What was the trigger that adjusted course for you?
I think it was about 5 triggers all at once. And, you know, if I've done a lot of counseling this year, I've done a lot of therapy this year. I got into a business about a year and a half ago, and honestly, it outgrew me. So many people that depended on my leadership and showing up every day. And the more people you work with, the more glaring your own weaknesses can become. And you know what? I embrace it. I accept it. I feel so blessed that I'm in the position that I'm in, because some people will never be in a situation to have to work so hard to develop. And, you know, pain sometimes just drives us a little bit harder and a little bit faster. And, you know, there were so many things in my personal life. There were so many things in my spiritual life, in my business life. It so many things crashed all at once. And it's been, you know, there's a book that I've been reading lately, and it's called Rising Strong. And it is the journey of rising back up after you have been knocked straight on your back is where the growth and the development is in life. And kind of my new thing I say every day is, you know, I tell myself these, the first place you want to start your day is with the Lord. And I want His affirmations over my life, not the world's. And so, you know, one of my things I always say, and looking back on my life and where I've been, is I was made for the grind. I embrace pain. I embrace trial because it is absolutely growing me, and I want to grow. Your looks will fade. Your money will go. Catastrophe will happen in your family with your children. But you know, as we root down stronger in who God says we are, and that joy comes from within and not circumstantial, not from how much money I'm making, not from the praise of man I seek, but it's going to be who God says I am every day, leaning into Him, finding that peace and joy in Him, because everything around you can crash and fall at once. And when that happens, it is the greatest time for growth. And I love growing. I love moving. I hate being stagnant. And there's times we have to be stagnant, and we have to be in that waiting room, and we have to be patient. But I'm just, you know, when life is pressing in, it is where we can turn it, face it head on, and lean into God and grow. So
that is great. And Rob, if you want to pop up that graphic that we have of her, that she was made for the grind, I'm going to say hi to some people. John Piper in the house. Welcome. Joni is here. And Joni says she loves your filing system, which I love too. Stacy Baruka is in the house. We've got Candy is in the house. Mia. Again, we have some really, really great people. And the reason we're chuckling, Joni, is because that's part of my rockstar guide to getting it done that Abby has participated in. She is a rock star for sure. But I love that picture of her. I was made for the grind, because that's Abby, right? And she's learning how to balance that grind too. It's not all about put your nose to the grindstone, 80 hours a day, you know, and getting crazy. It's about you know, balance, and it's about, but getting in there and not being afraid to get your hands dirty. You know, we're going to go back again just for a second and talk about, you know, we talked about a Christian home. You also played at a Christian college. You were also a basketball coach. You were a basketball star. You were, you know, you had some other things going on, you know, that started building you up to this place. And so I want you to talk about that. And I want you to talk, because one of your articles said, and I'm looking at this, that I became a train wreck spiraling out of control. So I want you to talk to us about that journey and what that train wreck was. What happened that started the train wreck for you? Or starting you considering it a train wreck?
Well, I feel like every time in my life I've been built up and been on that peak, it's been absolutely taken away from me. Starting in high school, where like all I ever knew in growing up in Indiana was that I was going to get a D1 scholarship. I was a 5'10 point guard with a rocking 3-point shot, and then 3 torn ACLs later, I ended up at a Christian college. But it was my basketball from first to my senior year in high school was an absolute job. And most of the girls who played with me quit and got burned out. And I got to go on and play at a Christian college with my sister, and we had a blast and we made a lot of memories. Train wreck. I got married very young. We moved away. We were in isolation away from community and didn't have a support system and had a lot of struggles in our marriage. I developed some like unhealthy food issues. I went through miscarriage after miscarriage, lost jobs. I actually struggled with substance abuse at one point, my early 20s, masking just pain, and really lost myself and who I was. And it took a bit to bring me back. But, you know, any parents out there with your children, walking astray, it's always, I love the story of the prodigal child. All you have to do is lay the foundation, and someday, you know, hopefully they'll come back. And I feel like, you know, that's where we're at. We're constantly making a comeback. So, which I can relate to people, you know, and I like that. I love people, and God's given me definitely some platforms, using stupidity, using pain to minister to others. So my siblings can't relate sometimes to what this crazy can relate to, but you know, whatever, we can speak to others based on what we go through.
I love that piece. And Nikki, you know, my assistant, when she's transcribing this, you have to use that part she just talked about, the using the stupidity, because I think, you know, that's it, it's, we use it in jest, because I always say that we don't fail, right? They're always stepping stones, these stepping stones that lead us to where we are. And the fact is as hard as it is, there's really, you know, there's a financial remuneration in our pain, right? There's a remuneration. Sometimes it's financial because we write a book or become a speaker. And I know you do speaking engagements to try and encourage people and give them hope as well. But there's this internal remuneration. We earn blessings in our own heart and joy from sharing with other people and watching them not have to run off into the ditch. You know, when you can see someone who's about to hit the wall because you've been there and you're like, you really need to slow down. I'm telling you, you're going too fast. You know me, I have my 3 S's, right? Slow down, stabilize, and systemize, because, right? Otherwise people will end up in a place they don't need to be. And our experience gives us that direction. Without that experience, it would just be words and platitudes going blah, 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 that people couldn't absorb. But experience is what gives us the strength and hope and gives us the credibility for other people to listen to what we have to say. And so, you know, and really quick, I do want to give some more shout outs because I'm so excited that we have such a great group of people here. John, you're asking about the broadcast and why it looks so great. That's because of the audiovisual team here at Enlightened Audiovisual. Mr. Rob Hicks and Mr. Sam Gonzalez in the background are making our lives easy. Abby and I are just sitting here like two schoolgirls kicking back, and they just make us look good. So if you guys are are interested in that, you guys can contact Rob Hicks or you can contact Ms. Jenny Q, who can give you the information. Again, if you want to step up your game in live streaming, if you want to become more legit and more authentic, this is the way to do it. So again, I highly recommend that. It'll be in the show notes as well, so you can just click a little link and get the information you need. But, you know, again, if you haven't shared it out, please do. Those of you who are listening on iTunes and Stitcher, again, thank you so much for, I hope that you get as much out of it, but I'd really love for you guys to check out the live broadcast. Again, go to YouTube, go to VickiFitch.com and hit the Vicki Fitch Live tab. There's just so many places that you can get this information. Abby will probably have it on her website, which is Abby K Life. You can follow her. And again, we'll have a show card at the end. You can follow her everywhere at Abby K Life and get inspired. Because again, I have to tell you, this girl was made for the grind. She gets up, she hits it, and she shares it all with you, raw and real. She, you know, she shares it, her ponytail. She shares her workout, which I have to tell you, you look way too good working out in cowboy boots. I just kind of want to slap you. Yeah, I just so want to slap you, right? I'm just like, her, she looks good no matter what, right?
You've seen me in my pajama head. I know you have.
I love it. I love you like that. I see Vincenzo Landino in the house as well. You know, again, Abby, you have rocked the world. You're rocking people's worlds by giving them this inspiration. And the fact that you just touched on a few topics, you know, that we want to dive a little deeper too, because this is where that bully gets in our head, right? You know, you touched on substance abuse. You touched on the fact that, you know, you've shared before that you had an eating disorder. You touched on the fact that, you know, at some point you were working out 10 hours a day. All of these things were to try and block out that bully, telling you you're not good enough, smart enough, strong enough. But so let's talk about some of those things. What launched you into there and what helped you traverse that? Because I guarantee someone that's listening to this podcast either is having eating disorders. They are, you know, finding themselves either addicted to sex, to TV, to video games, to, you know, something, to drugs, to alcohol. And they want to know, how did you get out of it? Like, you know, how did you get there? And then what is it that started to pull you out?
Right. I think, you know, I've identified a lot over the last couple of years. One thing I just have to state out loud is I have an addictive personality. I have an extreme personality, and it has been my greatest strength and it has been my greatest weakness. And not being healthy, not understanding triggers that are going on that lead you to pain, you'll often mask that with a behavior, and it can become addictive because it's a coping behavior. And, you know, so I think the first place really starts with inner health and knowing yourself and checking in with yourself. You know, in our company, we do what's called a DMO, daily methods of operation. And, you know, part of that is just every morning. And by the way, this is, if you read the book, Tools of the Titans, a lot of the millionaires and entrepreneurs and people with success in life, they are always checking in with themselves, starting with the day. And if you don't identify the situations around you that are causing you to feel a certain way, then it's very easy to say you will start masking them with unhealthy behaviors. And so, you know, for me, it just depended at what time of life I was in. But, you know, when it was really young, like I said, it was substance abuse. When I had moved, I had gotten into a gym and I used working out and figure competing to draw myself out of substance abuse, to stop masking the pain. Like, I had serious issues I needed to work through. I never worked through the loss of my babies. I would go on and I would just compete and I would just work out and I would take control over my food. It was control issues. And, you know, I began forming a new identity in the competition world as that figure girl. And I realized when I was in the figure industry that there are so many extreme people in there that are running from the same thing. They may not be at the bars at night drinking, but they're in the gym 2 hours a day or prepping their food. It's addiction is kind of the same across the board, whether the community thinks it's a healthy thing or not. not having balance is not healthy. And after I was in the world long enough, I had my success, I ran my game, I started coaching women. And I wanted to help them transition out because I began finding freedom in not having to compete another season and another season that had held me captive. I didn't know who I was anymore at 15% body fat because that doesn't look extreme. If I didn't have my abs, how was I abs renewal? Like, I identified myself based on what I did, how I ate, how I looked, and being a little bit elite. And there was some arrogance in that. But as I began to coach more women, I realized there were very few who could come out of that world without developing that addiction or that egocentric, where it didn't matter if their children got put on the back burner or in the nursery for 2 hours after they had already worked 8 hours at work. You know, so just learning that no matter what it is, whether it seems healthy or not, addiction is addiction. And, you know, my journey then began to evolve. I decided I didn't want to be a part of that world anymore because it wasn't healthy for me. Right. I love the world. I love the transformation and the hard work that goes into taking your body to an extreme level and back out, but I saw too many women lose themselves. And not to say I would never do it again, but it wasn't healthy for me anymore to be around the arena mm-hmm. until I got something healed in me. I could be out to eat at a restaurant and I would be disgusted watching people eat pizza. That's not healthy. You know, I would be counting every calorie, measuring everything that went into my mouth, even when I wasn't competing. That's obsessive. Right. So, you know, part of my journey then was figuring out how to work with regular people because they didn't want to eat every 2.5 hours. They didn't have time to weigh their food, count their calories, check their macros, download the app, get to a gym for 2 hours after they're coming off a 9-to-5 job. They didn't have the luxury of doing that. And I have found in this community, I've gone down a rabbit hole in the last 2 years of what we call the high fat, low carb lifestyle. Mm-hmm. And the reason why I'm such a huge advocate of it is because it did liberate me from food addiction. Because I realized when you have a higher fat diet, you are more satisfied. You don't feel like you're white knuckling through a diet and calorie counting. And it's, you know, when we're full, we're happy. Right. And so when you're happy, it's sustainable. And that has been why I've chosen to coach more within the paradigm of a high fat, low carb world. I see it healthier for women, their hormones, all the studies, science out there is turning towards that. We're finally, our culture, our Prove It community has really highlighted a lot of this science creating this culture. And I'm passionate about it because of my background and where I came from. And that liberation, I think it brings people to only eat maybe 2 meals a day instead of 6, you know, not bashing on that lifestyle. It's necessary sometimes for single digit body numbers, but I couldn't leave it. I was addicted to it. And so that's kind of how we enter into the nutrition part and the liberation that I want to bring other women. They can still look good, feel good, and they don't have to be obsessive.
Well, and I think too, you know, and I want to take a minute really quick before we dive into that and talk about some of the people that are here. Kathy Mixon is in the house. Thank you for being here, Kathy. She's going to read the books that you've identified there. You know, Stacey Lynn was saying, you know, all the issues of control, which happens when you feel out of control internally, which we both know is true. That's exactly what happens is that we're so desperate to get control that we hold on so tightly. It's like sand sifting through our hand that we can't hold on tight enough for it actually to do any good. And then I see Tina Stricker is here. She said, this is so true and it's great information. So you're a rock in the house right now, Abby. And Santri, thank you for being here. If you guys, again, that are watching live, if you would do me a favor and actually hit out that share button, again, only if you're finding value, because what we want to do is make sure the Evict the Bully in Your Head series is really near and dear to my heart. Because again, as a child, I I really felt like I knew I was, but I didn't feel like I was good enough, strong enough, or smart enough. You know, as just, you know, sharing a little vulnerability, some of you know, my mom used to call me a black cloud coming into her home, right? I know she didn't mean that, but I was so happy, but everybody else loved me. But in my own home, I didn't feel good enough or strong enough or smart enough. And it was always disappointing. It was always discouraging the minute you walk in the house. And then, like Abby was saying with her dad, you know, like, oh, well, you didn't do this and you didn't do that. And you got straight A's, but you got excessive talking on your report card. And it was just like, I don't even want to be here. And I bet some of you are feeling that right now. You're feeling like, I don't want to be here, wherever that is. Maybe it's in your home. Maybe it's at your work. Maybe it's in your own mind, in your own body, saying, I'm tired of this body being, you know, heavier than I want it to be. I'm tired of this body being tired, and I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired. I'm tired of this addiction. I'm tired of my frustration. I'm tired of trying to control things that are out of my control. So Abby's here to try and encourage you guys. I hope that you're listening to her words where she said, I was out of control. I was doing things to gain control, and all it did was spin her out of control. You know, and I don't know if you have the courage, and if you do, I'm going to send you some private message and give you some private encouragement. If you don't, it's okay. But if you've felt that way in your life and you're here live, I'd like you to put a one in the chat box. And I promise you, I will send you a private message to encourage you and motivate you, because I don't want you to feel alone. I don't want you to ever, I don't care how old you are, or how young you are, you're not alone. This journey is real. The struggle is real. And we're here to support you. So I see my bae, Miss Mia Voss, is in the house. Lori Berger is in the house. You know, Jay, it is the bully in your head. And Kathy, thank you for sharing it. I truly appreciate it. You guys are such an awesome group. And again, you know, Abby, thank you for being, you know, so open and vulnerable. You know, the people that have downloaded the podcast, again, I hope that they'll come and check out episode 12 with you know, Abigail. You know, it's, we call her Abby K, but it does say Abby Klutz on there. I hope that you guys will check it out, because again, she's laying it all on the line here so you guys can heal. You know, Abby, you talked about another part of that, you know, losing children. Rob, if you can put Abby back up here with me. You know, I lost a child, and I know it nearly wiped me slick. You know, I mean, honestly, I thought I could handle it, but I stuffed it, you know. Feel it. People said to me, aren't you over this yet? Like after a week, and I'm thinking, oh my gosh, I remember saying to myself, am I supposed to be over it? I guess I am. Like, that's what you do. You just pick up and go on, and we shove things down and then they come out later. I call it peeling the onion, right? Because we shove it like a dump truck down, and then we explode over absolutely nothing, when really it's this pain that we covered up. And I don't know if you're willing to talk about that, Abby, but you know, what did that push you through?
Oh, that was really tough. It was, I'm such a act the way you want to feel type girl. And I have a lot of trouble being vulnerable. Not as much these days, but, definitely for a long time. And if it hurt, I found a way to get busy. You know, so it between, you know, that was really hard. Losing the child, I was also pretty isolated in a community at the time. I was pregnant with my sister, she went on. We were supposed to have them together, and there was so much excitement around Christmas and leading into the holidays. And I always still look at her little girl and think about, you know, the cousin at that age we would have had together. And you know, but I didn't deal with it at the time, and it'll pop up in crazy ways, but I got busy. I got busy with competing. I got busy with work, and I've been on, probably up until the last 9 months, I've been in busy mode. It's just did not have time to stop and process things, stop and heal with things, because I don't know where I learned this, but you don't cry, and you don't talk about your pain. I don't even think I learned it from my family. I think maybe just being an athlete, it's something I internalized. I liked to be tough. I didn't want to be seen as sensitive. So, you know, it's part of why I've gotten so much success in whatever job or industry I was in. But I'll tell you what, there was one day where I just realized I was so busy that it was affecting me as a mother. And that's, I think that could have been a trigger point where I said, I've got to deal with some issues in my life because my working or my competing or my eating to take control and escape feeling is going to lead me into being a mother who's disengaged because I'm running and that's not healthy. And so going through the pain, learning to embrace pain, it feels good. It really, it's not as scary as we think it should be. And, you know, I think grabbing those Christian sisters, I think grabbing that counselor, grabbing Vicki, you're my mentor, and being able to talk through, dig through, just put these things in the right categories and mourn them so they don't transfer over into unhealthy behaviors. Right. It's huge. It's huge in just being a healthy person and then being able to give yourself to other people more wholly. So,
well, and recognizing, see, I think that's the problem is that so many people don't recognize it. They are, you know, my dad used to say children should be seen and not heard and not seen too often. Right. And then that whole, you know, what are you crying about? What's your problem? Like the word choices that people would use would put down our feelings and emotions to where we did start to stuff them. We started to look at that as weakness. And I, you know, that old adage about, you know, don't confuse my tenderness for weakness, right? Don't confuse what I've got going on here to be weak, because I am not weak. I am strong. I am strong maybe for the right reasons, maybe for the wrong reasons in your opinion, but don't confuse my tenderness, my kindheartedness, or my tears for weakness. And, you know, there's, you know, Stacey Lynn shared that, you know, she's felt that way at times. Mia Voss is here and she loves the dialogue. And, you know, I'm super glad that you're here, Mia. You know, I adore you and I had such a great interview with you. You're awesome. Jay, the bully in your head is the most unspoken problem with people's emotional health. I think you're absolutely right. That's why I wrote the book, Evict the Bully in Your Head, because there's so much pain and we don't have to be alone. I remember being alone with my pain. I remember going to bed every night and crying, like, right, just crying and going, my family doesn't love me. Like, I really felt that way. I know in hindsight now they loved me. They just didn't know how to love me in my love language, right? They didn't know how to not judge and try and control. I looked like I was 21 when I was 16. My dad was worried that somebody was going to hurt me or take advantage of me, but I didn't know that. You know, when we don't learn to communicate effectively, it harms the relationships in our life. And when we don't learn to let that out, as you know, I always say, I think tears are like a pressure cooker, right? If I don't have the opportunity to let the tears out, I'm like a pressure cooker that's going to explode. So whenever you see me crying, just think of a little thing on the pressure cooker going tick, 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 tick. You know, it's releasing pressure so I don't lose it, right? And so we want to make sure that we are here for each other and that we recognize that having the pressure cooker piece is okay and that tears do not make someone weak. Again, you can say what, if you would have said it back to me when I was younger, you know, tears make you weak, I would have tried to suck it up, right? I would have tried to suck it up, go, I'm cool. Now I'd be like, you know what? I don't have time for you right now. I'm busy crying. When I'm done, well, we can communicate because I'll have released that. And so the fact that you are doing that, you know, Nick Rishwain is in the house, whom I love, and he's being sarcastic, saying he cries himself to sleep every night. That's because you don't have me singing you a lullaby, my friend. That's what it is. But, you know, as we get back to you, Abby, you know, and your kindness and your consideration for others, you know, you've gone through depression, eating disorder, self-esteem problems, but you have turned things around and started adjusting, like you said, a different lifestyle, right? You've decided to have a healthier lifestyle and you are, you know, using exogenous ketones. We're going to talk about your life and we're going to blend some of that stuff in. Cause I think a lot of people are really interested in what did you say you did? You changed your healthy, what, high fat, low carb, what, you know, they're very confused at the concept and very excited because I have to tell you people, bacon is involved here. And I personally love bacon. If you don't love bacon, just forget I said that. But for those of you who do, you totally get where I'm at right now because bacon is really good. Now you can't have the chocolate covered bacon. That's out right now, but you can have bacon. So, you know, and really quick before I transfer it over to you, yes, Mia Voss is hilarious. She's insert pressure cooker image. I love that, Mia. We're gonna definitely use that. And, in order to be vulnerable, you have to be a strong person. Revealing your vulnerability is a choice and exercising it is strength, no matter what others think. Mic drop. Boom, Jay. That is exactly it. Thank you for capturing that so beautifully. And again, you guys are bacon is life, Mia. That's right. So tell us a little bit about, you know, exogenous ketones. We're going to talk about direct sales and stuff like that because, you know, that's been an industry that's become really powerful for you. But let's just talk about this piece right now about what ketones do, high fat, low carb. Why is it good for you? And how did it actually help you to heal and adjust course?
Yeah, I think, well, you know, this journey for me started, I had left the figure industry. I was doing CrossFit. My muscles were prettier than they were functional. I, you know, went too hard, too soon, too fast, and ended up with a pretty severe back injury. Basically a whole lot of inflammation and nobody could really help. And, at that time I got a call from a former business partner. His name was Brian James. And he said, "What do you know about ketones?" Mm-hmm. And I had been desperate. I had been on electronic stem cell. I had been taking painkillers, because I would sit at my computer for 10 hours a day making nutrition programs. I couldn't sit more than 5 minutes. And so I was desperate to find a way to get rid of the inflammation in my body. So I turned towards the ketogenic diet. Mm-hmm. It's very healing. If you've never looked into it, just go Google it, read about it. But I just actually got back from the low carb Breckenridge, where top experts and researchers and scientists from all over the world came into the community. There's types of cancer that can actually be healed using a ketogenic diet. Not all of them, but some of them. I met a man with stage 4 cancer this past weekend who used the ketogenic diet, is in remission. He was 70 years old. There's some of them that can be, but a lot of people with medical conditions have started using this because eliminating those sugars, eliminating those carbs, they are seeing major health benefits, especially with the expansion of even free radicals and oxidation and cancer. So a lot of people practicing it for literal medical applications. However, it's become popular. It's become popular because a lot of people who have struggled with food addictions, who have tried the yo-yo dieting, who can't stop sugar, once they can transition from being a sugar burner, getting rid of it in their body, then their body will convert to using fat for fuel. The cravings diminish. And what happens is your body starts using fat. It converts it through a process in the liver, and it produces what's called ketones. So if you follow this very strict, very hard diet, you can, instead of using glucose for energy, use ketones. Your body will make them. And ketones, we know, are a greater fuel source. They deliver 38% more oxygen. They pass the blood-brain barrier, help heal inflammation. They help people, children, you know, with seizures. I have a friend who has had Crohn's disease. People are using it for the healing effects. However, a year and a half ago, I got a call that we that there was a technology at the University of South Florida. They could biohack into this compound your body would make, and it was a bioidentical compound, and we were going to put it in a company and deliver it to the marketplace. So it would be the first therapeutic exogenous ketone. So the difference is endogenous, you have to do a very strict diet to create these ketones on your own. Exogenous, you can drink them in a drink and you can still have the benefits of more energy, just feeling better. And there's a myriad of things that can happen, but I'll let people go and research that themselves so I can stay very compliant on this video tonight. But for me, it was, it could run in my system for 4 to 5 hours, could keep oxygen coming in. It kept my metabolism from downregulating, mm-hmm. and it suppressed my appetite and cravings. And if you know, have been on this the whole time and you go back to the way I was addicted to feeding, mm-hmm. and portion control and calorie counting, being able to drink that and not have to eat all the time to keep mm-hmm. my metabolism running with food, it's been profound. You know, so before we even put it in the company, I was able to sit at the round table with some researchers, millionaires, scientists, extreme athletes, and really feel and experience what this was doing. And I started sampling it out to people, and the feedback was astounding every time. What is this? Oh my gosh, I didn't need my nap at 3 o'clock. I wasn't having
right.
cravings. I can control things. And a year and a half later, this company has put out over 15 million servings. We've launched in Canada. We've launched in Australia. Well, not officially launched. We are direct shipping to Australia, mm-hmm. and they are loving it. But it's really all about experience feedback. You know, you can talk later about network marketing, but what we know is people are oversold in the health industry with supplements. People have right. tried everything. They've been promised everything.
Right.
And so, you know, leading into the market with this, it's been all about user experiences and inspiring others by just being authentic with your journey on it and being able, you know, to just share what's happened. And I tell people all the time, don't believe me. I send them to the Prove It Facebook page and I let them read the thousands of stories of people who took that risk, tried it. And it's changed.
Well, and I think the fact that you're here right now talking about your story is where there's some validity, right? Is that people are saying, you know, you came from this place of difficulty, you know, and I know, you know, Adam Nally is a fan of the show. He's here all the time, Doc Muscles, and he is part of your team actually. And he has come on as well and shared different pieces. I can tell you from my own perspective that I'm hypoglycemic. And, you know, I have struggled with that since I was 18, you know, making sure I eat every couple of hours. When I started working, and I always say it wrong, so it's exogenous instead of exogenous. Okay. Exogenous, like erotic. Okay.
Exogenous.
I'll work on getting that right. But when I started taking those, all of a sudden I wasn't having to test my blood sugar. I wasn't feeling like, I felt like I was on a roller coaster sometimes. I'd be on the treadmill and all of a sudden, like I had just eaten breakfast, bacon and eggs, breakfast, and I'm on the treadmill. All of a sudden, I'm like, oh my gosh, like my blood. And all of a sudden, I check my blood sugar and it's so low. I'm barely, you know, I'm barely alive. It's like, you know, 58 and I just ate. It's just like, it should not drop like that, like a ton of bricks. And I was getting headaches and felt crappy. And ever since I started, you know, taking those, I haven't had to worry about it. When I went to the Tony Robbins event and we're 18, 20 hour days, I didn't have to, I just kept drinking them. And I thought, this is so weird, because even when I've been on different things where I'm drinking, I'm always hungry. Again, as a hypoglycemic, my body processes things differently. And if there's nothing solid in there, I always feel terrible.
Yeah.
And I didn't feel terrible. And I kept looking and see, I came with from a very critical perspective. Like I came going expecting to have problems. I had my blood sugar kit. I had my glucose, you know, in case I'm out, just in case something would happen. I had expectations that it wouldn't work. So when it did, you know, I was excited. And then, you know, I wanted to lose a few pounds and I wasn't losing weight. And then I got this, well, are you really eating fats? And I was like, no, no, because as a model, you modeled as well. But, you know, in the fitness industry, I was never as thin as you, but we were always, we don't eat avocado. That's a waste of calories. We don't eat, you don't drink heavy cream. You don't put cream in your coffee. You know, yeah. You drink black coffee because that's no calories. You know, it was just a different mindset. So for me to all of a sudden start eating bacon and eating avocados and stuff, it was weird. And I couldn't quite wrap my head around it. So it's a different form of thinking. And so, you know, before we came on tonight, I did a Periscope and a Facebook Live. And one of the questions was, like Stacey Lynn Harp said, what are high fat foods that are healthy? Like people want to know what can I, cause again, I struggled with it. I didn't do it for weeks. Like, I'm like, you know, I'd drop a little cream in my coffee and I'd be like, oh, no, you need more fat. I don't want fat. Fat is fat. Like I think of the word fat and I think of my thighs growing or my face getting fat or my arms, but that's because that's the way we were conditioned. So share that high fat foods that are healthy.
It's crazy. We really should flip the pyramid upside down, and no research study has ever said you get fat from fat. You get fat, you get heart conditions from sugar, from carbohydrates, and if you're watching this tonight, do not go out and start eating fats in addition to the diet you're on. I have that happen with people, and that will make you fat. So you know, you really need to choose one fuel source or the other. And I find everyone who's ever tried it loves being a fat eater, fat burner. So, you know, let me just run you through a typical day. I think people want to know, what do I eat? How do I eat it? And for me, that liberation, it comes through intermittent fasting. Now, you can wake up, you can have your eggs and bacon and your avocados or an omelet, leave the yolks in, stop throwing them away. Those are really healthy. But for me, I get up and I put, it's called a keto cream package, but it has MCT and coconut oils in a package. And some people have referred to that in your coffee as bulletproofing your coffee. Mm-hmm. So I take a package that has those good healthy fats in it and I put it on a Ninja and it's real frothy and I'll sip on that for like an hour. Mm-hmm. And then when I start feeling a little bit of that hunger, I take the ketones. They suppress the appetite. They give my brain that energy. I can get 8 hours of work done now, intermittent fasting, in the first 4 hours of my day. I am on it. As Vicki, we're ninjas. Like I'm just, and I'm not worrying about, you know, I used to have 3 meals in my tummy by 12 o'clock. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I've had 2 drinks. I'm still not feeling hungry. 1 o'clock rolls around. That's when I'm thinking about higher fat food, moderate protein. So you've got, you know, if you're out working, you have your Cobb salads. Instead of getting any kind of dressing with sugar, think about a ranch or oils. Think about almonds, cashews, nuts, cheeses, avocados, chicken, salmon. You know, those are your meats, good portion meat, but do heavier fats and then keep your carbs out and minimum. A lot of people doing this high fat world, they try and keep their carbohydrates below 20 or 30. I personally don't count vegetables as carbs. There's so many trace amounts in nuts and things of carbohydrates. But then about 3 o'clock, 2:30, I find a lot of people start derailing. It's actually time during the day where your cortisol start raising, your brain starts getting tired, and you think you're hungry. You think you need that Pepsi. You think you need that candy bar. So many people at desk jobs, they're bolting to get something to munch on. Mm-hmm. And so I put those ketones in with my clients around 2:30. They feel that brain energy, and all of a sudden what they thought was hungry, it was just they needed that wake up. They needed that oxygen. Mm-hmm. And so it suppresses the appetite, carries them through. And I tell people to sit down, enjoy your dinner, roast your vegetables, use butter, use oils, avocado oil, olive oil, you know, and for snacks, I have, they're called fat bombs. Sometimes I'll do that with the ketones in the afternoon. There's recipes on Abigail Life, but you know, it's just, or you can Google fat bombs, but there's fat cookies. One of my business partners, her name is Maria Emmerich, and she wrote The Ketogenic Diet, amazing recipes. Also, Jimmy Moore with Keto Clarity has an unbelievable book that breaks it down into layman's terms on how to do this diet. And like you said, Vicki, follow Doc Muscles online or ask Dr. Heather on Facebook. These are good thought leaders who always produce good content and recipes and right. foods people want to know.
Right. Absolutely. And so there, you know, as we're talking about, you know, these different pieces and how to get better. And we got to remember, you guys, that again, you know, we're here, we're talking about this, the bully in your head, and we're getting new ways, right? When that bully is telling you that you're fat, right? Because we know a lot of bullies tell us we're fat, even if we're not fat, you know, even if we're not, when we're not where we want to be, we use descriptive words that we've heard somewhere to describe our body. You know, and I always say we need to remember to start using language that's supportive of who we are. You know, I want to make a change. I want to adjust, you know, I want to be thinner. I want to do this. We can use words that aren't attacking ourselves. Like, for instance, I said on a broadcast the other day with, or I think it was last week's broadcast, one of my friends is, you know, she does the UJAM workouts and, you know, she's 50 years old and she looks like she's 25. She, you know, makes everybody jealous. And I said, yeah, well, I have, you know, during the time of buns of steel, I had buns of aluminum foil, right? They were not, you know, I wasn't fat. I just wasn't rock hard, right? So we got to look for ways to describe things differently. We have to look for ways to say, I want to make a change, not that there's something wrong with me, right? And it's okay for you to want to change. And so we're giving you some tools here. We're giving you some opportunities to say, hey, I want to make a change. You need to make it for you, not for him, not for her, not for them, not for the other bullies in your life that tell you that you're not good enough or that you're too heavy, you're too tall, you're too short. I want you to evict those bullies. I want you to stop listening to them, because what they're saying is they're passing on their own frustrations, their own judgments, and their own bullies in their head to you. And I want you to stop listening. But if you want to make a change, I want to be healthier, I want to adjust course, I want to change, then that is what we're giving you the information for. We're giving you information to make an adjustment in your course. Now, I see, you know, Cliff Sanders is in the house. Bacon is alternative truth. Kale. Okay. I don't know. I had kale yesterday. I got to tell you, I'm not a fan of wilted kale. Just note to self. Not a fan. You know, Jay has a serious question. Did we get together with similar earrings? Really, Jay? Are you that blind that you can't see my tiny itty bitty earrings and you can see her big earrings? Like, at, you know, really? Because that's such a boy thing, Jay. Like, let's see. The mess, ma'am, involving an issue when attempting a sustainable reach out of misleading cycles of moving backwards. Ooh, Michael, you're getting like so deep there. People have to read that like 5 or 6 times before they can like totally like meditate and marinate on that one. Joe said, I worked with a spiritual coach for a few years and we talked a ton about vulnerability and ego. Been applying this to your personal selling and sales coaching and a huge shift. You know, Joe, that's one of the things that I really appreciated about you when you and I talked, because again, I found you very authentic and funny and fun. I'm so looking forward to having you on the show. Kathy says she's on the ketogenic diet and those exogenous, did I get that right, Abby? Exogenous ketones are amazing. Where in the world is Tony Mobley? I don't know Tony, but Tony, hopefully we'll get you tagged and you can come on in here. And Stacy wants to know about peanut butter. She wants to know about peanut butter. And oh, Doc Muscles did show up. He is here talking about my buns of aluminum foil and the hot cross buns that led to it. So Adam, thank you very much for kicking me in the butt, in my aluminum foil butt. But they will be buns of steel one of these days. I'm just going to keep watching Abby's workouts while she's in her cowboy boots. And I'm going to get rid of the flab under my arm. I'm going to be so rock solid when you guys see me that when I make my move, I'm going to like knock something over. So what about peanut butter, Abby, as you know, share that. Stacey wants to know, is peanut butter okay? Is almond butter okay? What should we do?
Doc Nally's on, man. He should be taking over these nutrition questions. But, you know, peanut butter, that can be really dangerous because I don't know too many people who can have one or two tablespoons. Well, let me correct that. Too many women who can have one or two tablespoons. And I really like peanut butter with chocolate. So for me, that is a spiral out of control. Remember my addictive personality in the beginning. You know, if you want, you got to be careful. You got to see what works for you. I know I can't stop at one tablespoon. So if I haven't eaten all day, I could probably afford a couple. You know, they also have trace amounts of carbs. So you just got to be careful. Those will sneak up. So,
yeah, right.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, and you know, and Adam broke my heart, Doc Muscles, Doc Nally, whatever we're going to call Adam Nally here. He broke my heart one day. Can we just talk about that for a minute? Because I love popcorn.
Yeah.
I said, if I put a lot of butter on my popcorn, he was like, no. I'm like, that's so not cool. Okay, that's just not cool. So I'm not allowed to have popcorn, or like, I'm not having popcorn. Although he told me if I have only one cup, you know, with butter, then I'm okay, because it's still, you know, putting me in my low carb zone. So, you know, there's hope. And I don't have an addictive personality, so I can stop with one cup, right? I mean, my husband has a completely addictive personality. Like, you give him something and he just, boom, he dives in. Video games or TV, he's like, you know, he's immersed. But I can do a cup. I don't want to. when I'm eating the cup, I want to keep going. So right. I try and stay away, because, you know, I you know, it could happen, you know, it could happen that I would extend that. So peanut butter on my popcorn probably would not be a good thing either.
No, you got to be careful. Carbs or fats, pick your fuel. Don't combine the two. That's kind of my philosophy now. And yeah, Adam, I'm peanut butter triggers me to want chocolate with that peanut butter. So and like Adam said, pork rinds are great. And Vicki, I roast my kale. I'm like you, I don't want the wilted. So I'll take some foil, lay that kale out, put on some butter or some olive oil, and then I roast it so it's a little bit crunchy. So okay. Yeah.
Do you melt the butter first? We're moving into recipes really quick, just for a minute. So, do you melt the butter before you put it on, like you do in olive oil? And then,
yeah. And one thing that I found useful is, there are these spray tubes where you can pour any oils you want in them. So if I can pre-melt my butter, it helps give me more control over the usage and get it over everything.
Okay.
So, get a good spraying utensil. So.
Adam, you're mean. Adam wrote, chocolate covered popcorn dipped in peanut butter could be really bad. He knows chocolate is my weakness. Chocolate and caramel. That's why Chocolate Johnny used to always really get me, because as soon as I would see his name pop up in the chat, I would be like, oh, like immediately you go, you know, your mouth starts salivate. Yeah. It's just wrong. It's just cruel, right? It's just cruel.
here's my new go-to for all you sweet tooth cravers out there. We just released our new chocolate ketones. So now when I've struggled at night, all I do now is take some hot water. I take those chocolate ketones, and I'll give you a little trick. I learned this from the world's number one strength and conditioning coach, Charles Poliquin. Put a little bit of glutamine in with those chocolate ketones. Absolutely suppresses the sweet tooth and appetite. And so that's what I do at night now. And it's made a huge difference. So
like, you guys, we're so lucky that we, you know, keep getting poor Mia says she got her brownies today, because I do treat all my guests like royalty, right? And so she got her brownies today.
And I'm killing brownies.
those are keto brownies, really. They really are. Just eat them up. No.
They are.
Abby's like, we're not going to fake people out. That's just not happening. Chocolate Johnny is in Australia. I got to get him to make ketone-based Aussie chocolate. You do, Adam. That would be awesome. And what about peanut chocolate fat bombs? Well, I think there are some recipes. I have a fat bomb cookie cookbook that somebody sent me that was really awesome. And I know that you have recipes on abbykaylife.com. I know Adam's got some recipes on the duckmuscles.com. And, you know, there's just so many, there are so many, many opportunities. And yes, you know, job security. I hear you, Adam. You know, as we're going through this, and I would love for you guys, if you have some questions here, pop them in the chat box right now. This is your chance. I'm going to ask her a couple more things, but we want to open it up to you. And no, it doesn't have to be about food. It can be about food. It can be about ketones. It can be about anything she shared today. It can be about the bully in your head and how, you know, don't be afraid to ask questions right now. Don't be afraid when there, if there's something gnawing at you. You know, my pastor always says that there's, you know, when, if I'm talking to you right now and there's something gnawing at you saying, I really want to ask, but I'm afraid, you should ask, because you're in a safe place. Abby's not going to judge you. I'm not going to judge you. And if anybody in this room judges you, then they just have an issue that they're trying to work through themselves. So don't be afraid, you know, own up to whatever it is you want to know. If you're struggling with something that Abby can help you with, ask her right now. I mean, you have her undivided attention. She's here to serve. She's here to share. I mean, she poured her heart out, and she's also got wisdom in an area of health and revitalization. I know that also, you know, you guys know that I have a son that has Asperger's, and ketones can help focus, can help that, you know, different things. It can help people that are struggling with, you know, with diabetes and I mean, and inflammation. I've been in a car accident and I had all this inflammation and this struggle. And there's just so many wonderful things that are here. So I would love for you guys to pop in some questions that you might have. And while you're doing that, you know, Abby, I hate to kind of dance around a little bit, but you have had some really great success. People have really been drawn to you. You even have another company, a tea company that you're involved in called Castle and Fables. And so I'd love for you to tell us a little bit about that while we're waiting for some of these questions to pop in. You know, what is it about that company? Why did you get involved? Because you are a serial entrepreneur. You see opportunities and you kind of bring them under that umbrella.
Yeah, absolutely. I had met a business partner out of Toronto, Canada, and it's where the tea headquarters of the world is. And I always loved Teavana. I loved the gourmet teas, but I thought they were so outrageous and very expensive. Also, people are surprised to hear this. My background is in college. I was an English literature major. And so very much into stories, poetry, all things beautiful, and had really gotten out of touch with that side as I chose down the fitness industry. And so about almost 2 years ago, I partnered with him and we started a tea company. And I adore this tea company. It's called Castle and Fables at castleandfables.com. It's an online seasonal tea club that sends you gourmet teas fitting for the season. And every tea has a story. It's tea was formed in around in the castles where they would take that minute during the day to, you know, exhale, talk. And this tea company launched at the same time as Prove It. And so I had just barely got it up and running. I got the product. I've got it up. It's gorgeous. I put it on hold for just a little bit. It's going to be resurrected. People can still go there and order it, but I'm certainly not at a phase in my life where I'm driving it. But it is my passion, and I'm excited to someday get back to it, because I believe if you can take that moment for tea, it affects your whole day. And that's been part of me and my journey and practicing the balance and the moderation, is identifying, okay, I need to step away. We have 1,000 things on our plate to do, and kind of the things that, when I was starting the tea company, I was thinking about what are my values and where can I keep anchored? And it's first part of my day, giving it to Jesus, block scheduling my time where I'm with my people, I'm serving my people, I'm growing my teams in network marketing. I'm not just in it for the health of the exogenous ketones. Right. I am in it for financial freedom. You know, I've shared with you, Vicki, as well. My first 10 years of marriage were spent in apartments and trailers and food stamps and insecurity. And so if I can attract somebody to, you know, a product and a lifestyle that changes their life, then my passion is in coaching them to bring up that financial situation and how to build teams, how to serve other people in that same journey. So that's where the life is right now. But, you know, the tea reminds me, definitely take that moment in the day, take a break, find out, reassess where does your direction need to be going back to. Count your blessings, as my grandma always says, while you drink tea, count your blessings.
Absolutely. Well, and you know, and the thing is that the reason I brought up the tea company is because I think that we do need to engage. You know, I've been taking like at 3 o'clock every day, right before my son gets home, after I'm done, you know, I try and do my client calls up until 3 o'clock, and I try and take a break at that time and have a cup of tea, have a cup of decaf coffee. And I think we should start a little movement. It's March 1st, you know, it's March 1st, 2017. I think we should order some tea from Castle and Fables, and we should have a little tea club where we're, you know, taking a picture of our tea and posting it online and saying, you know, hey, I'm just going to take 5 minutes. I mean, take 5 minutes for yourself, because balance in your life is really important. Balance stops you. It gives you a chance for the pressure cooker. Maybe you need to let some tears out at that moment. You know, maybe you have to feel something that's going on. Maybe it just gives you a minute to just say, you know what, this is what's happening. So I would like to really encourage you guys to do that. And I know that, you know, Abby has a couple things of exogenous ketones that she wants to give out. And I would love to know if there's somebody in here that really wants that, that's ready to do like a 5-day start of some of those ketones, and you guys want to try it, put one in the chat box right now and let us know. Those of you that are listening on iTunes or Stitcher, I apologize, this is not available for you, but you can go to her website. Do you have the connected up to Abby K Life right now? Because I was there earlier, I didn't see the connection to order your exogenous ketones from there. Did you have that? Are they there, Abby? Is there a link there for them to order that? I think she's going to check. Abby, can you hear me?
Oh, yes. Where do you want it?
Well, just tell us. I mean, we can put it in the chat box, but
yeah, there's a link on abbyklife.com or absrenewal.proveitnow.com. Either way. Yeah.
Okay. abbyklife.com, and it's on which page? I didn't see it there earlier.
Yeah. Should be the front page.
Okay. Yeah. We'll find it. If it's not there, you guys can message me, send me a message, and I'll put it in. I'll put a link to that in here if you guys want to go check it out. For those of you guys who have downloaded on iTunes and Stitcher, it'll still be in your show notes. So you guys can click away on that link and get some of those. I see Cliff Sanders is interested in those. He's been here the whole time, definitely contributing. Frank Preby, I don't know if I'm saying your last name right, is in the house. Dr. Ralph Carden did a great presentation on stress tonight. Excellent, Frank. Glad to hear that. Michael's here. Cliff found it. Thanks, Cliff. Nikki Ramos is in the house. And, you know, you guys are awesome. If you haven't shared this out yet, click that little share button and make sure you share it out, because Abby has delivered a great story and some great information here. And again, if you guys are interested, besides Cliff, we do have some other opportunities for a couple other people. I highly recommend it. If you're not sure, or if you're feeling, oh my gosh, I'm so selfish, like I don't want to take the free prize, take it. Okay. Don't be dumb, because seriously, it can change your life. I mean, I'm telling you, I was very skeptical. I kind of approached it at like, you know, with a, okay, well, let me disprove this if it's disprovable, because that's just kind of the way I am. I want to make sure that I'm safe and what I say is really accurate. And I found them to be extremely helpful for me. So again, check it out, try it out for yourself and see what you think. While you guys are kind of thinking of that and seeing, oh, there you go. Rob put up your website, abbyklife.com. Isn't that a beautiful picture of her? If you guys aren't, again, those of you can't see, she's such a lovely girl. She's lovely inside. She's lovely out. It's just such a great opportunity. And we thank you so much, Abby, for delivering that. Kathy Mixon says, take it. You won't regret it. She's a big advocate. And Jay Mackey is, you know, saying that's so awesome. So again, there's so many people here that are really supportive of that. So Abby, I also know that you have a goal to be a speaker, that you've already spoken a lot of places for a lot of things, but your long-term goal is to be able to speak to people about growing through trials and taking control of your destiny, to talk about health and self-esteem and inner beauty, but also to share it not only with the health community, but with the Christian community, and to just spread the word to people. And I just want people to know here that, you know, she is available as a speaker, and you will not be disappointed. You probably heard how articulate, how passionate she is, how communicative she is, and how much she really loves people. So I'd love for you guys to consider her. And Abby, you know, do you have some speaking goals or some things that you're trying to target specifically so people can help you with that? I always say if you throw out an actual legitimate specific ask, people have an opportunity to really help you come through with it.
Yeah, honestly, I do want to start with a book. I have this huge book in my head. So it needs to get written. And Vicki and I, we've talked about this before. And I'm excited to get it on paper because I know once that happens, then everything will start following. Honestly, right now, I just feel in my life that I am, let's see, I have this, sometimes the Lord calms the storm and sometimes he lets the storm rage and calms his child. It's a little poster I have up right now. And I know right now I am sitting in a storm holding on, and God is doing some amazing work in me, and it is just going to add to the story. And I am always wanting to be right where he wants me to be in his will. I love speaking. It's a passion of mine, but I love just being, learning to be authentic, because I think I've hid a long time and it doesn't feel good and it's not healthy. And so if we can, you know, let God use our testimonies and our trials and see his glory and redemption and how he can, you know, trade beauty for ashes. If I said that right, I want to be a part of whatever he's wanting to do. That's all I want to do.
Yeah, son, you know, we want to be in his will, right? And we also sometimes know that we're just in his grip. And I love that phrase, because even when I feel like my life is chaotic, you know, I have a favorite Bible verse, and it's Isaiah 41:10. And he says, you know, do not be afraid, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. And I think of literally when my life is going wacky, so you guys can totally get your mental visual picture here, right? I think of God holding me up here in his hand, and like the earth is like way down there. Like I'm so far away that nobody can touch me. I'm just sitting there in his hand, and you know, my daddy, he's just my daddy. He's got my back, and I'm just sitting right there, and it's quiet, right? And that's what I think about when I get overwhelmed or stressed out. Instead of going to hide in the closet, which, you know, could be like an indicator, like I just want to get away, I just sit here, and I think I'm going to sit here with my tea now, and I'm just going to imagine myself up here in his righteous right hand, because it's okay for us to feel that way, right? It's okay for us to say, I don't have all the answers and I don't have it all together, but to come together as a community, watching this broadcast right now, I hope you're feeling inspired. Listening to this broadcast that you've downloaded, I hope you're inspired, because that's what we're here to do. We're here to tell you you're not alone, that you're not wrong for the way you feel. There's not something wrong with you, that we want to adjust your thinking. We want to adjust course, and we want you to have a foundation that says, okay, I'm going to make a change for me. I'm going to make a change because it's the best thing for me, that I want to be healthy and I want to be better. So I hope that you guys have gotten that out of today. You know, I do want to pop up, Abigail has another favorite quote, and we're going to pop that up really quick as we're kind of wrapping the broadcast up. We have about 8 more minutes. And she says, sometimes I believe in 6 impossible things before breakfast. Now, I love that, right? I love the fact that she lays it on the line. There are so many people that don't get up until noon, right? Abby gets more done, you know, by 10 o'clock in the morning than most people get done all day. And so, you guys, try and remember that you can do 6 impossible things before breakfast. Stop limiting beliefs. Stop thinking that you can't do it, and evict the bully in your head. That bully telling you you're not smart enough, strong enough. It's a lie. It's a big old fat lie. And I want you to start thinking in positive terms and saying, instead of saying, I can't, say, how can I? How can I be different? How can I lose weight? How can I have more energy? How can I connect with that community? How can I achieve my dreams and goals? Because that's the direction that you want to go in. Asking every day, how can I? Those 6 impossible things before breakfast are from you saying, how can I do that? How can I inspire other people? So, you know, Cliff says he loves the 15-minute timer. This is a great broadcast. Thank you so much. Kathy is inspired. You know, I think that there's just so many things going on here that are elevating the, you know, elevating the people, elevating the community. And so, you know, Abby, I only saw, Cliff is the only one I saw that wanted the ketones. Like, I can't believe nobody else is there, but does anybody else want some ketones? Do you know Cliff already, Abby?
Well, I'm watching all my people on here and I know they have their own ketones, so they're being very polite.
Gotcha. Yeah. Well, I know a lot of mine don't, and I know some of them do as well, but you know, Adam's funny, you know, you can do 5 impossible things before breakfast. Well, Adam, you do 5 impossible things before lunch, so it's okay. She's a girl, you're a guy, we'll give you some slack, but you know, you can step up your game, brother. It's time. Okay, Jay Mackey says he wants some. Jay Garrett said he wants some. So there,
good,
we go.
Okay.
There we go. I will connect, you know, I will connect you with the people that you don't know, and we'll make sure, as a matter of fact, Abby can go through the comments afterwards and she can send a message to you, because again, we want you guys to check it out. We want you to try it and see if you like it. It's okay if you don't, but I think you will. I think if you actually utilize them, I think that you'll find that you have more energy and that you don't feel hungry, because that's kind of a weird feeling, right? We're like, we're used to being hungry. Like, I'm feeling like, wait, what's wrong? Like, shouldn't I want to eat? You know? And the fact that you can eat pepperoni, I just have to say, is kind of a cool thing too. Bacon, pepperoni. I like high fat meats. I didn't eat them before. Jay Mackey deserves ketones. Jay Mackey, if you guys don't know Jay, he's a rockin' graphic artist and illustrator. He's done the book, my Evict the Bully in Your Head book. Wait till you guys see it. I've been keeping that cover under wraps because it's so freaking awesome. I mean, seriously, it's awesome. And he's done a great job. Sam says, he's talking to Adam, but you guys, okay. So we have a couple other things to do really quick before we wrap up the show. We have a great sponsor. If you guys know Archon Mounts, Archon Mounts is an incredible company and you guys can save some money. They even have this new light ring, which I have to tell you guys, if you don't have this yet, you got to get it, because, you know, everybody's always telling me how my lighting is so cool. You know, I have a lighting over my head. This thing has 3 different sections and it can adjust. It's only $13. Go to archon.com. These are back ordered right now, but you can still get the discount by using the code FitchSlap. I'll use all my live streaming gear. Again, Archon, ARKON.com. And again, use the code FitchSlap. If you guys don't know my broadcast, he said, red said, where red is always right. Then you don't know what that is, but trust me, it's not a bad thing. It's a good thing. And you'll have to check out my broadcast there. We are on the hunt for he, but I do have some pretty good candidates. We are starting, he said, red said again on Monday nights on the, I think it's the 8th of you know, this month. It's not this coming Monday, but the following Monday at 7:30 p.m. Pacific. And I have some cool guests. One of them, Mr. Joe Girard, who was in the house. I don't know if he's still here. Mr. Jeff Adams is going to be on there on the 8th. Joe is going to be on there the following week. And again, I have a really cool lineup. Joel Calm said he'll come back if we're going to let him, you know, I don't know. Are we going to let Joel back in? Because he can be real ruckus, that one. Ted Rubin said he'd come back. So we are bringing some of your favorites on as well. Ricky Prime said he'd come back. So we'll definitely dial those people in. We have next week, we have Mr. Ryan Bell here on Vicki Fitch Live. We are kicking off AR and VR month, where we're doing augmented reality and virtual reality. I know we have a card for that broadcast coming up next week. And there we go. And we have virtual reality and augmented reality. I have Ryan Bell, then I have Kathy Hackle. And then we have Social Media Marketing World. And the last week I have Mr. Robert Scoble. If you don't know about Robert, he'll blow you away with what he knows about augmented reality and virtual reality. It is going to be a stellar lineup and a fantastic month. Let's see. And then right now I'm going to, like, really quick, we have 3 more minutes. Abby, is there any parting words that you want to share with the guests to tell them? Because you have been so amazing. Again, so you've just shared so much from your heart. I really do appreciate it. What would you like to share with the guests?
You know, I just think summing up tonight, we had a definition thrown out there of vulnerability that was just awesome. And I think in that book I was telling you about, The Rising Strong, they says vulnerability is the willingness to show up and be seen with no guarantee of outcome. It's the only path to more love, belonging, and joy. And so I love that quote. You know, you've got rough times going on. You've got lies going on in your head. Take those thoughts captive. And for me, I check them against the Bible. I check them against the truth of God. You know, so you got stuff coming in. It's not love. It's not encouraging. It's definitely not of the Spirit. And so I just encourage you to take it captive and embrace Scripture for fighting and battling those thoughts. And I think, you know, your greatest thoughts, where your focus is where your path is going to be. So it starts with programming and letting this be a practice, letting it be a discipline, you know, start developing it, because what you're thinking will manifest into all areas of your life. So I think that's what we would sum it up with tonight, don't you think?
Absolutely. And when you're saying that, the fact is that those things that you're thinking are the bullies in your head. They're coming from somewhere, whether you're reading negative things, thinking negative things. There's so many pieces that get plugged in there that, you know, that's where the bully starts, right? I said it starts as a little bit of baby. And I'm perfectly aware that some of you don't just have one bully in your head. You have an entire gang of bullies that are beating you up on a regular basis, and we're going to help you evict them one by one. And I hope, Abby, what she shared tonight with you has given you inspiration and hope and direction and saying, you know what, I can stand up to the bully in my head. I can stop feeding, and I'm not certainly not giving it some exogenous ketone rocket fuel, because that bully does not need any additional fuel, right? So I want to make sure that you guys have a way to get a hold of Abby. I'm sure she's inspired you. I'm sure that you've connected. Rasan, I don't know if I'm saying your name right, said thanks to Abby. You know, Jay says Abby K is awesome in every way. Jay Mackey, you are a rock star with a pixel paintbrush. That's great, Adam. And Stacy says it's been a great interview. Again, vulnerability, the willingness to body check the bullies in your head against the glass for all to see. Adam, mic drop there. Again, you guys, this is fantastic. Kathy, thank you for being here. Thank you for being here, Jay. I'm going to share out Abby's card with you, her information really quick. I want you guys to take a screenshot here. This is how you can connect with her. It's pretty much Abby K Life across the board. Her personal email section is up there too. She does broadcast sometimes there, so you guys can actually follow her. But Abby K Life across the board, you want to connect with this woman. I'm telling you, first of all, she's someone to watch. She's beautiful inside and out. She will continue to give you direction and inspiration. You can go visit her website at abbykaylife.com and watch her live streams. Again, I have to say, the woman rocks the live stream. So she's a Facebook Live. We'll get her on Periscope here one of these days, but she's a Facebook Liver delivering value. And for those of you guys who don't know me, I want to tell you a little bit about myself, guys. Hey, my name is Vicki Fitch. I'm a direct sales expert. I've been in the industry 20 years, top 10 sales and recruiting internationally for more than a decade. I've also built and sold 4 companies. I'm an author, a speaker, and an international business consultant helping you get outside the 5,000 to turn your passion into your profits. So if you guys want a free consultation, go to VickiFitch.com/20. I would love to help you level up your game. I'd love to help you adjust course. I'd love to help you focus. And by the way, if you guys are interested in the information on Evict the Bully in Your Head, I forgot to put the link up today. I forgot to put it up, but we're going to have at VickiFitch.com/ETB, Evict the Bully. Maybe we did get it up. Maybe one of my VAs got it up, but ETB, you guys can actually register there so you know when the book is coming out, so you can get on the short list, get in on some bonuses and know what's going on. But again, I appreciate each and every one of you. Thank you for being here. I think Rob's going to throw my card of information up for you, but I want to remind you to come back. Like I said, this Monday, we won't have He Said, Red Said. Next week is Mr. Ryan Bell. Catch me on the live stream every day on Periscope and Facebook Live at 6 p.m. And until next time, I want to remind you, like I always do, to dream it, believe it, and achieve it. Ciao.